If you're new to Kajabi, a really common question that I hear people asking is, what's the difference between website and landing pages? And why should I use one or the other? In Kajabi speak, your landing pages are marketing pages. So anything that's part of a marketing or sales funnel, opt-in pages, registration pages, sales pages. Your website pages, in contrast, are more likely to remain static. Like your about page probably isn't going to change very often. Your landing pages might change more often depending on what you have going on in your business. So that's kind of how conceptually they're different, but they also function differently. And I'm going to tell you about that using an analogy. Okay, so your website pages are like aspen trees. And aspen trees, if you don't know, reproduce through their root system. So if you see a grove of aspen trees, they're actually all one organism and they're all connected by the same root system. So your website pages are similar in that if they're all connected to each other. So if you change your logo on one website page, that change is automatically going to be reflected on all your website pages. Same with your header and footer, navigation, links, colors in your header or footer, or if you change your font in your settings, that change is going to be reflected on all your website pages. Now, your landing pages are like pine trees. So if a pine cone falls off a pine tree and it grows a whole new tree, so your landing pages can have entirely different branding, header, navigation, fonts. Everything can be entirely different. So if you make a change to something on one landing page, you're only going to see it on that one landing page. So we're going to jump into Kajabi right now and I'll show you what it looks like from the inside. Okay, so we're going to go look through your pages now, your website and landing pages. Inside of Kajabi, you'll go to website and then pages. And here there are these three different columns, website, landing, and funnels. We're not dealing with funnels right now, just website and landing. So your website pages, every Kajabi account comes loaded with, I think, 15 website pages. And some of these login, library, and 404, these are pages that like grant access to your material, your courses, your programs. Some of these other pages you think of kind of as like comprising an actual website, about, contact, there's a home page. So just because these pages exist doesn't mean that people necessarily can get to them. You need to add these pages to your header navigation or give somebody a link. So I think that that's one thing that people sometimes get stuck on because these pages are here, but that doesn't mean that anybody can get to them if you don't want them to. Now, one quality of the website pages is that they're all going to have the same design theme because, again, they are aspen trees. They're all connected by the same root system. So if you want to know what design theme you're using or what your options are, again, under website, you'll go to design. And whichever design theme is currently active is going to be listed here at the top. So on this account, it's called Streamlined Home and it says live over here. So you can tell that that's what you're using. Now, if you want to try out different themes, because you can try them on, they're like outfits, you can try on different themes. You would go down where it says saved templates. You can browse templates. I'm going to open this in a new tab. Because these two, Premier Site and Carl, are outfits that I've tried on, but that are not currently active. So you can open up, I opened up that templates in a separate window. And it says template store, but these are all free. You can choose from any one of these. So if whichever one you choose, though, again, that theme is going to be applied to all your website pages. So kind of like the color scheme, the logo, the fonts, every one of your website pages is going to have the same one if you change your outfit. And if you wanted to change your theme, like if I wanted to use this Carl theme, if I just like set it to live right now, it's going to have this, it says, I think, cooking by Carl, and it has this guy's photo. So you would want to customize the theme, which you do by clicking this paint palette. You would want to customize it first to make sure that it works for you. And then you can set it to live by just set to live, or down here too. You can set to live there. And so, besides having the same design theme, your website pages will also have all the same settings. So, I opened up the login page here, and I'm also going to open up the 404 page. The 404 page is the one that, in case somebody clicks on a broken link or like a landing page that's in draft mode or something, or they type in the slug of your URL wrong, they're going to be directed to this 404 page. Okay, so this is my login page. It's still loading. So if we go to settings and let's say we want to change our font, I'm going to change the heading font. Right now it's Vera Sans, and we'll change it to Alice and then save. So you'll see this login that's Vera Sans right now, and then yeah, refreshed. So now it's Alice. So every other website page that we have. See, it picks up, it gives you this message, changes detected. Because every other website page knows that we changed from Fiero Sans to Alice. So they are going to all update their fonts. So there you can see that it's using that same font. Same deal with, so that's one of the settings. If you go to sections, your header and footer, that's also going to be the same. Like if we make a change here, and I'm going to, we got to display the header so we see what it looks like. So let's say I am going to delete this logo or hide it. Let's hide it. Okay, I'm going to save that. And now this page, well, again, we're going to have to reload the page. And so it automatically unhid my header. And so, and now that logo is going to be hidden. Yeah, it's got like the eyeball with the X through it. So just be mindful of that. Any changes that you make to any one of these pages, it's going to be reflected across all of these pages. I generally don't use website pages. I use landing pages for everything. They're easier to work with, they're better in terms of design and analytics. It's just for a lot of reasons, I find them easier to work with. And for most of these pages, you can create a landing page version of your homepage, about contact, thank you page, a few of these other ones that Kajabi just comes loaded with. However, there are three system or website pages that you have to use, and that's your login, library, and 404. So, just because those like control access to your content itself, so you can't create a landing page version of it. Those three pages you do have to customize and make sure that they're on brand. And I'm going to show you how to do that in a different video. Right now, we're just talking about landing pages and website pages generally, what the differences are. And then we're going to go over to landing pages. Now, your landing pages, these are all different from each other. They're not connected or related. If you change your logo or your font on this page, it's only going to show on this one page. And again, the same deal as with your website pages. Just because these pages are here doesn't mean that somebody can automatically get to them. You would need to give them a link or include it in a navigation menu. What you can do with your landing pages, if you have one, if just to kind of clear things up, is that you can change it to draft, just so that you can kind of keep track of which pages are active and which ones aren't. So you can, like all these pages, like I said, they're not related to each other. They could look totally different, but you don't want to do that. Like as far as branding and clarity, you want all your landing pages to have the same branding and header and footer navigation and to look the same. So that's the difference between your website and landing pages. Your landing pages can look different, but you don't want them to. You want them to all look on brand. So to achieve that, you can, and make it easier, you can create a template landing page. And I'm going to show you how to do that in a separate video. So this means that all your landing pages can be cloned from one master landing page, and then they'll have all the same branding, navigation, colors, fonts, all that. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.